أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صفيه وخليله، أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، إن الله تعالى يقول في كتابه العزيز: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا، واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا قولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My dear brothers and sisters, the theme of my khutbah is in the ayat that I read to you earlier. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear Him as He should be feared. Believe in Him and show your belief in following His orders and His command as it should be, and do not die but as Muslims, submitting your life, submitting your will to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, what makes you and me different from others as Muslims is that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah, the way we believe in Him is the proper way, the way that is worthy of the Almighty Subhanah, the Creator who created everything, who says to anything be and it will be. It is He Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, He is the one, the first and nothing before Him. He is the last and nothing after Him. He brought into existence everything. He is not confined by space. He created space, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is not subject to time because He created the time, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He shaped everything. He gave existence to everything. He is the one who gives life. He is the one who takes it. He is the one who will cause this world to finish and to end, and it will be different to the way it is, and He will raise us again in the Day of Judgment, where one of us will be held accountable for what he did in this world. Believing in Allah means that you are accountable for your deeds. Life is a responsibility. A day that Allah gives you is yet another opportunity for you to do better, to get closer to Him, to serve His deen, to serve His humanity, and to live. Everything you do should be done for Allah. إخلاص لله سبحانه وتعالى في الأقوال والأفعال. الله سبحانه وتعالى يحاسبنا على كل قول وفعل نقوم به. معاذ يا رسول الله أو محاسبون على ما نقول؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم تربتك أمك يا معاذ هل يكب الناس على مناخرهم أو على وجوههم في النار إلا حصائد ألسنتهم. Every word you utter, you are responsible for it. It's written as a deed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His kindness, He will reward you for your good intentions, even if you did not realize them in life, in the real world. You had them as an idea, you had them as an intention in your heart, you made the effort to do what you wanted, but you couldn't. Things prevented it, probably you died before you could do it. Allah, out of His generosity, will reward you for that. But had you made the intention for a bad thing, and you didn't do it, Allah, who knows everything that we hide and what we say, He will not hold you responsible for the bad thoughts that comes to your mind. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الذي ندعو له وندعو إليه وندعوه في حاجاتنا الخاصة والعامة. إذا سألت فاسأل الله. يا غلام احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. احفظ الله يحفظك. احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. Be mindful of Allah and Allah will take care of you. He will be there when you are in desperate need, when human beings cannot help you, when you think it is a desperate situation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send His help to you. That is what defines a Muslim, a believer. He believes in Allah the Almighty. He's the provider for his rizq. He's the one who gave him life. And if you believe in that, you would never be a slave to anyone. Believing in Allah is a liberating act. It's a liberating belief. You no longer believe that other humans control your life. Other humans, they provide for your life. Wallahi, law rizq. Law ja'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rizqa fi yadi an-nasi la baghilu. Walakinahu huwa ar-razzaq al-ghani subhanahu. يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب سبحانه وتعالى يعطي الكافر ويعطي الظالم ويعطي المشرك ويرزق المؤمن رحمته واسعة سبحانه وتعالى. His mercy is, has no limit and His knowledge has no limit. He knows everything. وسع كل شيء رحمة وعلما سبحانه. وحدوه اعبدوه لا تشركوا به شيئا. والله من توكل على الله نجا. ومن جعل مسألته عند الله قضيت. ومن توكل على الناس خاب. ومن اعتمد على الناس فشل. فاعتمدوا وتوكلوا على الله سبحانه وتعالى. إذا سألت فاسأل الله. Make your direction to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your life should be linked to Allah the Almighty. No one is bigger for Allah's will. Individual or nations or communities. Allah has the rich, He can reach, and He has the power to put an end to everything that He wants to do, so subhanAllah. After that, the Almighty, out of His kindness, He sent to us prophets and messengers. From Adam alayhi salam to Nuh to Ibrahim, to his children, to Musa, to Isa, and to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khatamun al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. Muhammadun la nabiyya ba'da. Huwa al-ma'sumu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ولا معصوم غيره في أمته هو النبي المبعث سبحانه وتعالى من آمن به واعتصم بسنته نجا ومن ابتغى الهداية في غيره ضل فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هو الدال إلى الله هو الدال إلى الخير قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Say if you claim you love Allah, then follow me and Allah will love you. There is no other way. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, his sunnah, his guidance is the way for believers. إذا قال صلى الله عليه وسلم صح عنه قول فهو المرجع بعد القرآن الكريم لا يجوز رأيت ورأيت والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قد قال قولا صريحا في المسألة لا يجوز أن نفتي والله سبحانه وتعالى قد صرح في ذلك بصريح الآيات ما حله الله فهو حلال وما حرمه الله فهو حرام لا يجوز لمسلم أن يحل ما حرم الله أو أن يحرم ما أحل الله ذلك ينطبق على بني إسرائيل بني إسرائيل they used to make halal what is haram and they used to make haram for people what Allah has made halal a Muslim does not give fatwa out of his opinion he uses dalil from the Quran and the Sunnah And from Salaf Salih, من قول الصحابة عليكم بسنة وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين. That is the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what it means to be a believer. This is what it means to be a Muslim. قالت الأعراب آمنا. قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. إن لم تؤمن. If you do not believe that Allah is one and He has no partners, then you can be a Muslim, but you cannot be a believer. Al-A'rab, they came and said to Muhammad, Muhammad, we believe. Allah told him, tell them that. Tell them you have not. Tell them, say you are Muslim, but you are yet to believe. Every believer is a Muslim, but not necessarily everyone who is among the crowd of Muslims is a believer. There were people who were hiding other things. Allah described them, pretending, showing the opposite what they hide. Allah called them al-munafiqeen. Al-munafiqeen, when the munafiqeen came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قالوا نشهدوا إنك لرسول الله. والله يعلم إنك لرسوله. والله يشهد إن المنافقين لكاذبون. The rank of believers will be filtered, will be tested, and the real ones will show, and the fake ones will be also be shown. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Do people think that they've left claiming they believe without being tested? You shall be tested in your iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who knows the real mu'min among us. We only judge people from appearance. And we do not pass judgment on people on wrong understanding or on wrong actions as kafir, as mubtadi' outright, and we close the door of Allah's rahmah to them and we say, you are an outcast. You are a da'i. You are a man who calls to the path of Allah. Let Allah make the judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our guide and our leader, Allah told him about every munafiq in his community. And some sahaba told him, Ya Rasulullah, well, let's declare them. Let's kill them, since you know them. He said, the Arabs would say Muhammad is killing his companions. How would anyone know? Somebody who attends the congregation with you. Only for a leader to make a judgment, but still you give them the benefit of the doubt and you accept them, but you should weigh what responsibility you give them. Do you know that in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a group of munafiqs, they went and established another mosque to compete with the mosque of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's called Masjid Dirar. They built a mosque, they wanted to divide the rank of believers. And there are today people who are actively, purposely, with intention, knowingly, they want to divide the rank of believers. They love to see Muslims quarrel among themselves. Because wallahi, my dear brothers, the real thing that is stopping us from realizing our potential is us, is the enemy within. It's often sometimes, knowingly or unknowingly, we act against our interests. And we make it easy for all those who would like us to be seen, who would like us to be weak and divided, so they can manipulate our life, manipulate our countries and our nations, and exploit our resources while we are quarreling among ourselves. Allah says in the second ayah to you, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا, and hold all of you to the rope of Allah. اِعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ الْمَتِينَ, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, Sunnata Nabihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we divide. Do you know what Allah told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ. Those who divided their religion into groups, you have nothing to do with them. Although the scholars, they, Mufassirin, they said it was revealed about Ahl al-Kitab. But some Mufassirin, they gave it the general meaning that still it could be applied to Muslims if they divide themselves into groups, you have nothing to do with them. You call for unity, for people to hold to the rope of Allah on the conditions we stated. Believing in Allah that He is alone, that Muhammad is Khatim al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen, that He is the only Ma'soom, and that we follow the Sunnah of His companions, that Allah chose for Him companions and Muhajirin wal-Ansar, and He said, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Allah is pleased with the companions of Rasulullah. Allah chose them for Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is those sincere companions who gave their wealth and their life for this deed. Wallahi, if it wasn't for Allah's tawfiq and their sacrifice, you and me would not have heard about Islam. But it is those sincere Muslims who took Islam. They left Medina, they left Mecca, and went out to the world to spread the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I was looking to Al-Hasan wa Al-Husayn, the children, the grandsons of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some historians, they listed to the places they went and the battles they took part. In one of the battles they took part, it was like 2,000, it was somewhere in Asia, 2,000 kilometers from Medina. They did not fly by plane. They walked and they rode horses and camels, going and coming 4,000 kilometers. The stretch of the Muslim Ummah is so vast, and it was not reached by planes. Wallahi, on horsebacks, on camelbacks, on donkeys, on walking sometimes. There were times when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could not find a horse or a camel to take those who wanted to take part in jihad. He could not find anything to carry them with, and they cried, they stayed behind crying, that they could not take part with the Muslims to spread Islam. And some of us, they have money, they have health, they have plenty of time, and doing nothing for the deen of Allah. And some of us, they want to make money out of da'wah, make business in da'wah. Muslims make business where you buy and sell, and they give their money to da'wah and to jihad. And some Muslims today, they want to make money out of da'wah. That is the difference. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu gave all his wealth for Muslims, to the extent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was touched by the generosity of Uthman. Then he said, Uthman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven him for what he did to the Muslims. He prepared whole armies from his own private money. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq gave most of his money to the extent that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Ya Abu Bakr, ma tarakta li abna'ik li ahlik? Qala taraktu lahum Allah wa rasulahu. This is the Muslims, those our ancestors, and we are witness to their legacy. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us follow their example, follow their steps, to realize our potential and to be productive and useful Muslims, because the Ummah needs every one of us. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah. الحمد لله رب العالمين أحمد وحمد الشاكرين وأصلي وأسلم على نبيه الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, our youth, they need our attention. I know that I do not need to advise parents to make sure their children go to school and get the academic qualifications to empower them so that they have a better job, a better opportunity in life. Probably you know it better. But I'd like to tell you that what our children need is these meanings that I talked about, to raise them as young men who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to live by the values of Islam. And Islam will be their identity. When they go out and they could probably leave your home to study abroad, they should have a sense of identity, to be proud individuals who fully have the faith and the confidence in their belief, in their religion, that wherever they go, they'll be useful and they can stand up to the challenges that come their way. And I can tell you the challenges are so big. And there is a process of corrupting our youth, to corrupt the belief, when the idea of evolution is sold as the standard, as the default explanation for Allah's magnificent creation, or Mother Nature is replacing God, this is where our boys and girls, they need to be strengthened. Everything they see around them should be linked to the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are never too young to understand that Allah is the creator. Give them that, my brothers and sisters. Take care of their Islamic education. Wallahi, if he is an individual with qualification, without faith, he'll be like anybody else, and there are plenty like him. But if he's a man of faith, a young man of faith, or a young girl who is proud of her deen, and she will not compromise her hijab, that are the youth that will make a change, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Wallahi, unless our boys, we take care of them to understand their religion better than us, and to implement it in their life, and live with the akhlaq of Islam. Ad-deenul khuluq, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, I'm never impressed by anyone, by his looks. The more he pretends, the more he puts an Islamic look, I examine him, yani sharply. And often they fail. Wallahi, there are those who are unassuming, unpretending. They behave often better than those who are putting a show or putting a pretense. Be a Muslim. Be genuine Muslim in your heart, in your actions, in your word. Let your actions speak. Dress decently, but without pretense. Girls, if you put a niqab, then behave like a proper Muslim lady. Not putting a cloth over your head, and everything about you says that you do not behave like a Muslim lady. It is the faith, it is the akhlaq that defines you, defines our boys and girls. When I see these boys and girls trying to cross the sea, going to another continent, risking their life and living behind a Muslim ummah that is so big, so rich, I say there is something wrong. There is something wrong. These boys have been fooled. They believe that heaven is on the other side of the sea, and they don't know the reality. How can we save them? How can we help them to make use of what they have and to believe that they can make change wherever they are? That is a challenge to all of us. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif 'anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma la tad'a lana dhanban illa ghafarta.